Greetings and salutations, all. This is Pride Ensemble. That's capital P, capital R, capital I, capital D, capital E. And we are here to entertain you for a short time. Enjoy all of the musical selections that are going to be rendered. We're going to get things started with, hopefully, you all will remember this one. I'm not going to give you the title. You should be able to name it yourselves. Thank you. Oh, yeah. Thank you, guys. That first selection, of course, I'm going to just let you know what it was. It's the Janet Jackson's mega hit, That's the Way Love Goes. But we played it instead of me trying to sing it. ColaJazz, we want to thank you for giving us this opportunity to do what we do as Pride Ensemble. So I'm going to take my time and introduce each and every member according to as they play and what they play. So I'm going to move over here to my left, your left, right, left, right, to one of the greatest guitar players that I've known over the past umpteen years, hailing from Bowling Springs, South Carolina. Listen to Mr. Eric G.J. Tyus with his rendition of Affirmation. Enjoy. Thank you. Yeah, Eric G.J. Tyus. We had a little Jonathan French in there. But I'm going to tell you a little bit more about him as we proceed through the concert. Thank you very much. The next tune we're going to take you to Salisbury, North Carolina. And we're going to feature on this particular number Jonathan First. This is one of my favorite songs because it's a feel-good song. And Brother Bill Withers, when he did it some years ago, it just became a worldwide hit. So I'm going to start it off with our bass player to set the segue on this. Hit me, Tyrone. Yeah. It's very recognizable. Yeah. That's what I'm talking about. I see somebody waving their hands in the air over there. That's what I'm talking about. Yeah. Come on. Hit me. Oh, yeah. Sounding good to me. Somebody stop with me. Come on. I see you out there. You know what? When I wake up in the morning, love, and the sunlight hurts my eye, something without warning, love, always lays heavy on my mind. Here's what I'm gonna do. But then I look at you, and the world's all right with me. Just one look at you, and I know it's gonna be a lovely day, a lovely day. Oh yeah. When the days of life ahead of me seems impossible to face, someone else instead of me always seems to know the way. You know what I do, Ty? But then I look at you, and the world's all right with me. Oh, just one look at you, and I know it's gonna be. Since I don't have a chorus, I'll sing it myself. A lovely, lovely day, 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 lovely day. On keyboard, Jonathan French, y'all. Make it a lovely day, J Money. Come on. Someone else instead of me always seems to know the way. Let us see, say it's like this. Then I look at you, and the world's all right with me. Oh, yeah. Just one look at you, and I know it's gonna be a lovely day. North Carolina. Now, I think what I want to do is feature me, trumpet, flugelhorn, a little Herb Albert piece that I learned to love through life. And I'm not going to tell you the name of this one because there's so many different variations, so many different people sampled this tune, but we're going to do the standard version at this time. I might do a little chant, but it goes something like this. That's just a little funky right there. Yeah. That's what I'm talking about right there. Like I said before, this song has been sampled hundreds of times. Yeah. Just to make sure, I'm gonna check one of the guys, one of the samplers. He's gone now, but he sampled it like this right here. He said this. Somebody, one of the ladies said this right here. Biggie, 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 can't you see? Sometimes your music just so hypnotized me. Now I just love your flashy ways. That's why they're broken, you're so paid. Biggie, 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 can't you see? Sometimes your words just hypnotize me. Now I just love your fancy ways. That's why they're broke. Hit me one time! But I'm going to give credit. The credit is due. The man who wrote this song, 1972. It's a beautiful hymn for trumpet players. It's real smooth, real sweet. But Pride Ensemble, let's go there. We're going to do their rendition of it. And it's beautiful. I'm going to start real smooth in the pocket. And then we're going to do something else with it. We'll be right back. rise. Rise. We're rolling. We're rolling. We're rolling. That last tune, y'all, I got carried away, of course. Rise by Herb Alpert. And I usually, when I'm performing, I do my double horn thing. Thanks to Frank Motley from Dizzy Gillespie's band that actually taught me how to do two horns simultaneous at one time. It's a method that we use both sides of our brain at the same time. But be that as it may, let's move forward. One of the nicest, most beautiful songs in our repertoires, and it's one of the most requested. We'd like to reach out to Brother Eric Tice again, and it's simply called Best Part. Do your thing, Eric. Thank you. guest spot, Mr. Eric Tice on guitar. ColaJazz. I hope you guys are enjoying yourself out there in ColaJazz land. We want to thank them again. Okay, you've met Eric. You've met Jonathan. You've met me. Oh, by the way, I'm H. Wade Johnson. H. Wade Johnson with Pride Ensemble. Let me introduce you to the baddest, in a good way, bass player that I know. All the way from, I guess I can say Colombia now because he's been all over the world. But I want you to set this up here, Mr. Tyrone Mack on bass. Tyrone Mack on bass. We're going to do one of the most understood or most recognizable bass melodies in the world. Mr. Tyrone Mack on bass.
Yeah.
I know you guys are going like, wow. You say, wow. Everybody say, wow. Wow. Say, wow. Now say it backwards. Wow. No matter which way you say it, still going to be wow. This time, I'd like to take this time again to thank my great brother, fellow trumpeter Mark Rapp, for inviting us to do this session. And before we close out, I just want to say thank you. ColaJazz, folk, all the support that you all do. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Continue to do what you do. Because not only is Columbia being affected, it's just so many different other musicians that come into town, all the wonderful programs that are being held thanks to the ColaJazz support. We're going to close things out. I've been holding it back all night. We're going to close things out. We haven't introduced the guy that keeps the back beat, the front beat, side beat, upbeat. Ladies and gentlemen, our percussionist. Notice I didn't say drummer. All the way from Charleston, North Carolina. Now living here, all the way from Charleston. Did I say North Carolina? Wow. See, when you travel, you don't know whether you're north, south, east, west. Thank you, Ron. All the way from Charleston. And I'm from Charleston County. Isn't that something? McClellanville. All the way from Charleston, South Carolina. Meet our drummer, our percussionist, Mr. Ronald T. Green. He's also the assistant director of bands at Benedict College, where I also serve as director of bands. We are all in Columbia, so I had to give a shout out to Dr. Rosalind Clark, artist in Benedict College. But ColaJazz, thank you for having us. Our last selection needs no introduction. Meet Ronald T. Green, and we're going to funk it out. Thank you all. Thank you all. Thank you all in TV land. We love you. Ron Green, what you got? Thank you. and gentlemen, once again, Pride Ensemble, Eric Tyus, Jonathan French, Ronald Green, Tyrone Mack, and me, yours truly, H. Wade Johnson. Columbia, ColaJazz. Once again, Mark Rapp and all the ColaJazz folk. Thank you, thank you, thank you, and good night. God bless. Have a good evening.
Well, hello, everybody. My name is Mark Rapp. I'm the executive director of the ColaJazz Foundation, and I'm sitting here with great trumpeter, double trumpeter, vocalist, entertainer extraordinaire, Mr. H. Wade Johnson.
Greetings and salutations, my good brother. Yeah. It's so great to see you, man.
Yeah, yes, indeed.
It's been a minute.
It's been a minute. It's been too long.
Yeah, you better believe it.
The very first time I saw you, I walked up on this cat, and he had two horns to his face. And he was just, I was like, man, what is going on? Let's dive right into this. When did you start playing two trumpets at the same time?
Wow. I got to go back to 1985.
So you were like 3 years old.
I was like 2 years old. But the great Dizzy Gillespie's other lead trumpet player from Shiraz. He was a part of Dizzy's band, and Dizzy came to town, and we all were performing. And I think I was looking at this guy, and he had both horns in his face. And I was going like, wait a minute, that's not possible. So I actually walked up on that, and he saw the expressions on my face. And he said, hey, kid, who are you? And I said, I'm supposed to be a trumpet player. He said, you want to learn how to do this? I lost my step. My knees buckled. And Frank Motley, the great Frank Motley from Shiraz, South Carolina, he said, I'll teach you. And so when he, you know, got with me, sat me down a few times and told me, he said, now, the whole gist behind double horn playing is you got to use both sides of your brain at the same time. I was like, no way. I hardly use a half of the side of that. But anyway, I have to give credit to Dizzy Gillespie's trumpet player and Mr. Gillespie because he showed me some tricks on the horn. And once I started practicing how to do it and got to learn how to do it, thanks to Mr. Motley. The thing about it is, it's very fatiguing. A lot of people don't see that in my shows, but they don't realize it's very fatiguing. Sure, I can do it as long as I need to be because I'm doing it, but it took me 7 years. 7 years of just practicing, like we say, trumpet players, we always playing long tones, lip slurs, scales, and all that stuff. It took me 7 years. I wouldn't say it's perfected, but it took me 7 years before I decided to try it in the show. People went nuts. Tips were great. I said, man, hey, I got something here. I don't consider myself one of the world's greatest trumpet players. Of course, my studies, my degrees and all of that stuff, they are what they are. But to be in this business, you understand, because you are one of the most phenomenal trumpet players that I've met in my life. And I remember when I actually first met you. I'm gonna go back. Oh, you were at the jazz festival in Savannah. Oh, wow. And if you don't remember, I was the guy with the raggy car that drove you around the city that took you back to your apartment. Took you back to the hotel. Ladies and gentlemen, Mark Rapp, I was his taxi driver. And
we
went back. And then the next night, we went to the jam session.
I remember now.
That was me. Of course, I had hair. And I was like 100 pounds lighter. <you know? laughs> Man, look here, man. I got to give you props. When I heard Mark Rapp on trumpet, I was like, okay. More practice time. Phenomenal. Because I always thought you were from New York.
Well, I spent some time up there. I'm a South Carolina boy through and through.
That blew my mind when I discovered that you were here. Because I've only been back South Carolina 6 years. Because when the gig you were doing in Savannah, I was actually living in Savannah.
Oh, wow.
For 1 year, that was 20... That was 2015, though.
2015,
that's,
wow.
That's six. Oh, wow. Yeah. And you were going so fast, and you hit and everything with the festival, and we happened to meet up.
I remember that.
Man, I was that guy. Yeah, I mean, so I remember this.
Well, that's a couple lifetimes ago.
Yeah, man. That's like, yeah. So thank you.
Wow.
Thank you, Brother Mark Rapp.
Man, thank you for that memory.
Yeah, man.
Wow, that just jarred a whole bunch of memories. That's incredible.
Exactly.
So let's jump back real quick. So where are you from originally?
I'm originally from a small town called McClellanville, South Carolina. Let me give the world a visual. McClellanville is in Charleston County. And once you cross the we call it the Cooper River Bridge, going 17, you hit Mount Pleasant, you hit Owendaw, and then you hit McClellanville. It's a blink of the eye. But we are well known. The Bulls Bay seafood and all that stuff. You get your seafood, it's from McClellanville, guys. I promise you. And thank goodness for the blessing from McClellanville is well known for Hurricane Hugo. It put us on the map, but it's a small seafood town. I call myself the little bean picker from McClellanville, South Carolina, because we always work the fields and whatnot. But that's where McClellanville. So you got Charleston, McClellanville, Georgetown, Myrtle Beach. Okay. Now everybody know where McClellanville is. Wow. Woo!
So you grew up in South Carolina, and did you discover music early on?
Being that I was in a high school, Mike, I wanted to be a professional football player. I wanted to be a running back for the, at the time, Washington Redskins. They are now the Washington football team / they are now the Commanders. I mean, I'm one of the greatest Washington fans in the world. I was born in Washington, D.C., but at an early age, my grandma came. And shout out to my grandma, Adeline Ball, we're actually celebrating her this weekend in McClellanville. Nice. And she was the one that came and got us from, we were at this place. Our house burned down. I was like 2-3 years old. So I have, you know, not many memories from there. But she came and took us back, brought us to McClellanville, which I was ready. But my musical thing came from getting hurt playing football. My senior year in high school, I got, my knee got busted, got blown, torn lateral meniscus and all, with all them technical terms. But I wanted to still come to the football games without paying. So I looked, I noticed the marching band. I was like, hey, those guys didn't pay to go in. They were having fun in the stands. They were having, food, the fun. So I approached the band director, bless his soul, Lionel Mackey Thomas. We didn't have a band at my high school until I was like a sophomore, like 70-ish. I'm telling my, I'm not afraid. 71, 72 was when Mr. Thomas came. But I thought I was going to be a football player. I played football, basketball, I thought. And I thought music wasn't for us strong guys. But getting hurt, and I went to him, and I said, sir, can I join the band? And at the time, the band was like 40, 50 people, so he was always recruiting students. My graduating class at Lincoln High School, the late Lincoln High School, Snowmore, in McClellanville, it was 65 of us in my high school graduating class. And I was a good student, but my senior year getting in band, of course, I hid in the band room instead of going to class. I graduated number 11.
Okay, that's good.
Out of 65. So I think I did pretty well.
that's fantastic. So you started Chumpet late then.
Yeah, man.
Senior
in high school. Wow. Thanks to my first cousin, Drexel Ball. His mother bought him a trumpet, but Drexel had asthma really bad.
Oh, wow.
And then he put the trumpet upstairs where I used to sleep. So it was a nice king trumpet. It was in a blue case. And I, you know, whether they say something like that, don't you bother that. I just sneak up there and touch it. So when Mr. Thomas allowed me to get in the band, I remembered, man, practicing, blowing on the horn. He gave me the fundamentals. And the lights would go out at my house. My grandmother wouldn't let me practice in the house. I had to practice in this little field next to my house. But it happened. But I didn't know that it was a gift until later on through my senior year when Mr. Thomas brought it to my attention. He said, hey, man, you're gifted. I remember my very first trumpet solo at Lincoln High School. He did an arrangement of Old Lincoln Spirit from Old Time Religion. He had it jazzed up and everything. And he said, somebody take a solo. And we looking, everybody's looking around like, solo, solo. And I was like, can I try? And let me tell you, and after that, he looked at me and he was like, wow. He said, you can hear. And so he started ordering. So what happened? I practically moved into the guy's house. He didn't live too far away from my home. And I spent the rest of my senior year, after school, I would go to Mr. Thomas' house. We, you know, do his lawn, do his house cleaning and all that. And trading for free trumpet, for free lessons, man. And it took off. So from that particular point, I had a scholarship to attend Allen University here in Columbia. But what happened, Mr. Thomas went to South Carolina State and played in the band there. So he took us to a football game at South Carolina State, which was then South Carolina State College. I never saw anything like that in my life. Never, ever. And I was hooked because I said, they are marching, they are playing, they are dancing, and they're doing this all at the same time. So he brought that back to Lincoln High School where I was. And so we started mimicking South Carolina State. Yeah. Man, the rest is history. Yeah. I auditioned. He forced me because I was scared. I was afraid. Coming from McClellanville to Orangeburg, that's huge. McClellanville being that small. And, you know, like going to Charleston, Georgetown, and Myrtle Beach. That's, like, man, that's the greatest trip in the world from McClellanville. But when he took us to South Carolina State College, I auditioned, was very blessed and fortunate. I passed the audition, and they gave me my first band scholarship, man. Wow. My grandma said, you know, we grew up in the AME church, which was Allen, you know, my pastor and everything. My auntie graduated from Allen. So, of course, you're going to. I remember the night that I had the audacity and unmitigated gall to say to my grandma, you know, because she didn't play. She was making a fruitcake in a dish pan. And I said, Mom, I called her Mama. I said, I'm not going to Allen. I'm going to State. Wow. She never looked up from mixing that fruitcake in that dish pan. She said, son, you can go to State, but you're going to have to pay your own way. Ooh. We as children with our parents that raise us, we don't believe that stuff, man. August 14th, 1974, her and my auntie took me to South Carolina State. She dropped me off in front of the campus. And I'm standing there like, okay, Mom, it was the money. You know, I'm going to be living in this dorm, which was Loman Hall. I'm going to live in this dorm. She started crying because I'm like, Mom, come on, stop it. She gave me, guys, world, I can tell the world. My grandmother gave me $2 and a pound cake. Mark, reality set in and it hit me. We're there crying. And I said, Mom, I said, Mama, I promise you, I will get my degree. That's the promise I made, us crying together. A pound cake and $2. I realized how tough it was back there in McClellanville. So that's why I always say I was a little bean picker from McClellanville, South Carolina. And the rest is from when she dropped me off. All the things in my life started revolving from South Carolina State being. I was not a music major first. I majored in English my first semester. Because I had a crush on my English teacher in high school. So I figured, you know, and I'm speaking very good English now because I grew up in McClellanville. We were Gullah. We had the Gullah lingo.
Right.
I can throw it if I need to throw it every now and then.
Wow.
I could throw it. And that started my musical career. And I had so many opportunities from then to now to develop into the person that I am. And I thank God for for all the traveling and all the people, meeting you, listening to you, all the trumpet players.
Yeah.
The first trumpet player I saw in person was Maynard Ferguson.
Wow. Wow.
In Augusta, Georgia. I was in the jazz band at State. We went. I put my trumpet up for 2 weeks.
I bet.
But realized I was majoring in trumpet, so I had to pick it back up. But that was phenomenal. Then I realized you have to practice. We make it look simple. We really make it look easy, but it's not. And I thank you for having me. You know what? Shut up, Johnson, because I'm long-winded, as you can see. But again, thank you, man. It's such an honor to be in your presence.
I appreciate it, man. I think it's a trumpet player trait. We are just long-winded people, man. I'm the same way. I talk, man. Just let me go. Man, that's incredible. That's deep. That's really deep. So you've got an incredible history of music in South Carolina. You've met incredible South Carolina musical royalty.
Yes.
That have come and passed. Who you know, you mentioned the lead trumpet player from Dizzy Gillespie's band, from Shiraw. Of course, our beloved Skip Pearson. I know you've got a big history with Skip.
My musical father.
So two things, and then, unfortunately, we don't have a lot of time, but I do want to end with two things. One, I'd love to hear you talk about Skip. And then two, I want to hear all that you're doing with your music education, with your students, where you're teaching, what you're doing. And, talk about everything. Ron Green is one of your cohorts.
Yeah.
And so those two things.
Okay, Ron, first of all, Skip Pearson, my other musical mentor, when I met Skip when he was at Scotch Branch High School. That's eons and eons ago. I remember the craziest thing that Skip taught me. He said, Wade, music is math, but music is this. He said, improvisation. That was a big word to me when I met Skip. And I said, huh? He said, improvisation, to improv. He said, you want to know what it means? I said, yes, sir. He said, improvisation means to improve every time you play. That stuck with me. I grabbed Skip Pearson's coattail, and man, he taught me so much with music, not just the musical experience and playing this, that, chord changes, all of that stuff. He taught me something about the business. Also, Fred Wesley, who lives in Manning, South Carolina, between Skip Pearson, Dizzy Gillespie, Frank Motley. Oh, wow, these are heavyweights we're calling. But Skip taught me that, to improve every time I play. And he says, anytime you get in front of an audience or by yourself, make sure you leave a message. Music is a message that brings universal love to one and all, man. And Skip, bless his heart, bless his soul. I traveled with him. I performed with him to and from across the country, man. And so thank Fred also, one of the greatest trombone players that we know. But Skip, that's the lesson that he taught me, to improve every time I play.
Wow.
Yeah.
I love it.
Yeah. Wow.
Yeah.
I'm sorry. I'm
mad. I know. He's
a little emotional with scale. Wow. One of the greats, man.
Definitely. One of the greats. Very special to all of us.
That's right. He was the ambassador.
Yes, indeed.
Jazz, and handed it down to you.
Yes,
man.
Indeed.
And you're wearing the crown well, my brother.
Well, thank you.
Thank you.
So tell me about where you are now. Where are you teaching, and who are you working with?
Ladies and gentlemen, I am now the director of bands at Benedict College here in Columbia, South Carolina.
There
now
it
I got to do this.
Do
home
it.
Of the BCBOD. Look here. This is year six. Ronald Green and I also, and we've been at Benedict for the past 6 years. So we've the growth, the support from our now president, Dr. Rosalind Clark Artis, who's the president of the Canine, but Dr. David Swinton was the one who hired me. And he retired right after I got there. I was like, oh, my God, what are we going to do? But when Dr. Artis came, she's boom. Shoo. The program, we've gone from 83 members in the band program to now we are projecting in August to have a standing membership of 250.
Wow.
And the band program,
wow,
comprehensive.
Wow.
Comprehensive band program. Marching band, concert. We have two concert bands, jazz ensemble, jazz combo, and all of the other instrumental brass, woodwind, percussion. It's phenomenal. Wow. It's phenomenal.
And that's great.
The coup de crew of it all now, we've been selected to represent the state of South Carolina.
Yes.
In the 2022 Macy's Thanksgiving Day Parade.
We represent
South Carolina and the HBCU system, Benedict College.
That's awesome.
That in itself is just a feat and a blessing, man.
So fun.
So much fun. We're gonna spend five nights, 6 days. Woo! In New York, man, getting ready,
man. That's incredible. Congratulations.
Thank you.
Yeah, man.
Thank you, Dr. Rosalind Clark, artist Ron Green, all of the people from Benedict College. Thank you all. Our support around the country, around the world. Alumni. Yeah, I got it. Alumni, faculty, staff, alumni. Thank you all.
Yeah, you're right.
Yeah, man.
You have 5 days up there, Macy's Day Parade.
Oh, wow.
You're going to come home and sleep for 5 days.
I probably will. Shut everything off. And I've been blessed because the campus, I actually live at the campus.
Oh, okay.
Right at the campus on Oak and Laurel.
Man, that's
Laurel
fantastic.
Street. So I'm always available for the kids if they need me.
Yeah,
I'm
great.
At the drop of a hat, boom.
That's great.
Something happens. So it's really a blessing in terms of my life. Best gig I had, man.
So how do we find you? How do we stay in touch with what's happening at Benedict? And we could where do we see you around town?
OMG. First of all, let me give a shout out to my wonderful wife, Miyoko.
There you
Miyoko Johnson. She saved my life. As a musician, so she saved my life. Thank you, Miyoko. We'll be around town. I usually play here in Columbia at Shay's Lounge. I call it Shay's. She is Shay, but she always corrects me. Shay's Lounge on 607 Meeting Street, West Columbia. But I play
right
there frequently.
The bridge, yeah.
If you go to her website, you'll see when I'm there.
Okay.
And there's some other places. I haven't been able to get out around town because I'm teaching.
Okay.
I'm the full-time director of bands. Yeah. It's a 12-month gig. So when I can get out, get out. And I've been watching you, man. You and I are going to hit. We're going to hit.
Yeah, I'm ready.
We're going to hit together real soon.
I'm ready.
I'm ready. I'm ready to get those lessons from you again, man. Trust me.
Man, likewise. I'm ready.
But thank you. Yeah, I'm now at Benedict College. My telly, if anybody wants to have it, is 803-290.
You better not give out your number. You're getting some weird people calling
Look here. I've had the same phone number for 40 years.
Okay.
803.
I know, right?
290-8181. Again, 803-290-8181. HWadeJ@yahoo.com or wade.johnson@benedict.edu. You can reach me there. I'm at Benedict College all the time.
Yeah.
It's my place of employment. Best gig I've had next to performing live and in living color with guys such as yourself. Thank you.
H. Wade. Yes, indeed. H. Wade Johnson, y'all.
Mark Rapp.
We'll see you next time.
Fuck up.